everyone.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
How's everybody doing? This is the 2022
Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Holiday edition of Ozzy Eats.
Yuletide carols being sung by choir.
Isn't that beautiful? Doesn't it set you in the mood?
Folks dressed up like
for the holidays. And everybody knows
a turkey and some mistletoe.
Hey! Isn't that beautiful? That's the king. That's the real king. Not King Cole.
With their eyes all aglow.
Singing a Christmas song from 1961. That's the king. Let's keep on hearing it. And I'll just lower it a bit.
We'll find it hard tonight.
Yeah! Merry Christmas!
They know
almost. Yeah, hope everybody's having a good time. Hope everybody's healthy, happy, and enjoying this holiday season. No matter what holiday you partake in, whether it's Christmas, Kwanzaa, what are the other ones? Hanukkah, you know, whatever. Whatever religion you adhere to, hope you enjoy this holiday season. Because let me tell you something, we've been through a lot recently. In the past, you know, couple of years, we've been through a lot, you know. But you know what? Let me lower this a little more. Oh, that's beautiful. We've been through a lot. But this is still your favorite quarantine, pandemic, apocalyptic, rioting, looting, pre-zombie, pre-alien probing. I'm still waiting for the zombies and the aliens to come down. They're taking the time because things are getting better now. Goya boycotting, Murder Hornets, Sharknado, batshit crazy Kanye, batshit crazy Elon Musk, stupid TikTok dances, kick him out of the White House, get him out and never let him back in, president, crazy Georgia runoff, cooking show. Yeah, ooh, that took a lot of effort. So I'm here in my studio, all festive. You see, I got the Christmas stuff here, festive. Provided by my sponsor, my new sponsor. Yeah, my new sponsor is Planters Lightly Salted Peanuts. If your nuts are lightly salted, they're probably Planters. Yeah, provided us with the goodies for the studio, Ozzy Eats studio, and yeah, you know, I'm getting it's a couple of days to Christmas, and you know, getting into the spirit. It's been a, as I said, rough couple of years, but this year was really good. The work has come back, all the clubs opened up, all the venues opening up in there, back to hiring musicians. Let me tell you something. Okay, I know, you know, I respect a lot the first responders during this whole pandemic stuff, you know, the nurses, the doctors, the police, the teachers, all the first responders. But let me tell you something, you know, when we came, us musicians came back on the scene, everybody showed us a lot of love. They showed us that they really missed live, in-your-face, live music. And they were tired of the radio and tired of the TV and all that. And they came out in droves to watch us perform, and they paid their money to watch us perform. And it's I respect that. A lot of my old groupies and fans came back out and said, you know something, we missed you. Maybe not you personally, because you know you're. They didn't miss me. They missed the scene. Well, some of them missed me, and I appreciate that. But they missed us. And come up with, you know, people that I've seen on the scene for, 20, 30 years that I've never spoken with came up to me and gave me a big hug and a handshake. And they said, thanks for bringing it back to us. And I said, wow, that really makes me feel special. You know, there was a time when I didn't feel wanted. Imagine that. That's why I started, this show, Ozzy Eats, because I had nothing to do. So yeah, so thanks everybody out there for, you know, getting us back out in the scene and dancing and eating to our food and dancing and falling in love again through our music and living your lives through our music. So thanks again, all right? So anyway, let me get out of this whole, sensitive stuff, okay? So I'm enjoying my beverage. Yes, it's, what is it? It's Stewart's Root Beer. Yeah, that's beautiful. Mac and Cole, that's the real king, okay? That's real king, Mac and Cole, beautiful. So, let's get on with the show. Got a lot of goodies for you. It's been a while, I know, everybody's been telling me, yo, when are you gonna put another show? I'm walking on the street and people stop and honk the horns. Ozzy Eats, when are you another show? But as I told you, the scene opened up. I've been doing, I did a couple of Broadway shows. The club's opening up. And so, yeah, I haven't had much time to think about it and to put this together. Because, putting together an Ozzy Eats show is a massive undertaking. Massive. So, anyway, and I want to give you guys the best show possible. So, now, you know what? I got a little time now. It's just great. It's great to see you guys. See you up there. You're doing good. See you up there. Hey, looking good. Hey, fantastic. As you can see, my shirt used to fit all tight and everything out. Look at this. I'm wasting away. And I'm running around. I'm still eating the same, but I'm running around and I'm wasting away. I can get new clothes. So, send me some stuff. No, I'm not asking for it. But I can still do this. Woohoo! Still got the guns. All right? Still do that. But anyway, so that's a good thing. I'm running around now, so I'm losing some weight and getting back to my old shape. But I'm still got the old and farty look. Man, get off my lawn! So anyway, let's give it a show. I got a cute little a recipe for you guys. So, people come over during the holidays and, you got the whole turkey and everything. You got everything there. But you need some trimmings. So I got this idea. It came out of this brain right here. Nowhere else. Just out of here. Hello, anybody in there? Oh, there's still something in there. Anyway, so to make a little cute little thing, a couple of things to put around the tree. So I got myself, you can write down the recipe for this. I got myself this, luncheon meat. Luncheon meat. It's like mini Spam. Spam. Because Spam is expensive now. It's like $5-6 for Spam. So I got this luncheon meat at Dollar Tree. My favorite store. Yeah, I still go there. Okay? So I cut it a piece like this, a little thin slice. See? Now, so I take myself a little knife. Be careful, it's sharp. A little knife. And I cut a pattern. Let's see what pattern I'm gonna cut. This here, I'm cutting a pattern. Voila! And this is what I come with. Come to, see? Isn't that cool? That's a Christmas tree. Christmas tree made out of Spam. A luncheon meat, whatever. So I got the extra stuff. So what you do with extra stuff? You eat it while you're making this dish. So, Christmas tree. Now, we need to decorate this Christmas tree. That's good. Hold on. Let me get one more piece. We need to decorate this Christmas tree. What can we use for decorations? I got it. So I got myself some blueberries. See? They're blue and they're berries. Oh, I'm not supposed to eat that. It's healthy for you. Anyway, blueberries. I put them on the tree. I use them as Christmas balls. Tree balls, Christmas tree balls. Okay, put some on there. Then I put some, you need something green. So these little peas. And then put some of the air in there for a Christmas tree. Christmas tree peas. Okay. Put something out there. Now to make it look more like Christmassy, I'm gonna use these rosemary leaves. Rosemary leaves. and they're like little leaves, right? So I sprinkle this on there to make it, oh, it smells Christmassy. Sprinkle it on there. Okay. All right. So far, so good. Now, then to add a little more taste, let me add bacon bits. Yeah. To make it a little zestier, as I always like to say. I'm gonna patent that phrase. Zestier. Can I? Anyway. I'll talk to my lawyer, Adam. Adam Thompson, get to work on it. Zesty. Can I patent zestier? Okay. That's my intellectual property. Ooh, this is looking good. I put my bacon bits. Now we need a Christmas light. The star, Christmas star, Christmas tree star. So I take a strawberry and I cut it into the shape of a star. It's not coming out too good. Hold on. I cut it into the shape of a star. Okay, shape of a star. Something like that. Now you need to add some snow. So, what do you for snow? Be nice. The crackers. Remember from my initial Ozzy Eats show? Crackers. I crumple it up like so. And there's the snow. I'm getting on the ground. Anyway, I got my own personal vacuum cleaner. Pio Pio. Anything that goes on the ground, she eats it. I got a story about that in a little while, I'll tell you. But this is looking so good, so check it out. It's a Christmas tree. Ozzy Eats Christmas tree. Isn't that cool? You make like five or six of these and you put them around the turkey, the main dish, and the little hors d'oeuvres that people can eat. Now what you gotta do with this, it's not ready yet. We gotta pop it in the air fryer for like a couple of minutes. Let's do that. Through the magic of television, through the magic of, see, I got a new, through the magic of editing, let's do that. I'll be right back. Hey, through the magic of television, I'm back. Ah! Check it out. So I popped it in the air fryer for like, 3 or 4 minutes. So check it out. Ah! It doesn't look cool. The bulbs are coming out, but yeah. A little Ozzy Eats Christmas tree for your table for the holidays. Isn't that cool? Yeah. And it tastes as good as it looks. Yummy. Spam is yummy. So anyway, let's talk more about Christmas and the meaning of Christmas. Okay, put my Christmas hat. Let me tell you a story. I went to the store, right? I want to get a Christmas, reindeer. So I went there and I bought this to the store. And I said, are these reindeer, horns? They said, no, that's leftover from Valentine's Day. That's the devil's horns. Oh, no, I don't want this. But I already paid for it, so here you go. I'll save it for... it's not reindeer horns. Anyway, so then I bought this. Bloop! Santa. Remember that my show a year or so ago where I invited Santa to come over and take over the show? He couldn't do it this year because he was busy. A lot more kids out there need presents. So he went around and get presents. So anyway, so what do you usually get? I tell you what I always get. It's not usually get, always get. And these are the stuff I need. Socks and underwear. Always. I need socks because, I walk around the house, in socks. And it picks up everything from the floor and, gotta either clean them or get rid of them after a while. They get holes in them, you know. People nowadays, they don't darn socks like good old days. They just throw them away, buy another pair. So I get socks and underwear. Well, you know, us old people, we need underwear because, you know, every time we sneeze, other stuff come out. Know what I mean? Yeah, every time we sneeze, you get some sharticles that come out. So, you know, gotta replace our underwears every, you know, here and there. So, yeah, so we get that. But you know something? The Christmas, this sounds getting itchy. Let me tell you something. Christmas really isn't, and it shouldn't be about presents or giving presents out. It really isn't. You know, as far as I'm concerned, and you know, Christmas is really a birthday. Yeah. It's a birthday of baby Jesus. Okay? We have to, you know, we honor his birthday by giving presents. You know, the initial three wise men traveled far, far distance to go to him and bring him presents, you know, fit for a king. You know, now, I mean, you know, you figure, you know, they gave him three things. Gold, well, you know, gold is gold. It's always been, you know, good for a king. You know, myrrh, which I don't know what the hell myrrh is, but if I understand it as a spice or something, myrrh, Google it. Okay, myrrh, they brought him myrrh. Now, the other thing, they brought him frankincense. When I was young, when I heard that, you know, they brought the baby Jesus, they traveled hundreds of miles bringing baby Jesus frankincense. I said, what are they bringing baby Jesus frankfurters for? Frankfurters, get it? That's what I thought it was. So they brought frankincense. Okay, hold on a minute. I'm running out of tape, so let me make some more room here. Hold on.